the FIFA shortlist. Any surprises in that one for the women footballer of the year, the first award after the separation between FIFA and the French
no
magazine?
surprises. Yeah, I mean, no Africans yet. No British woman also has made it. I think Kali Lloyd will win it.
Okay.
She's in it. We've got a couple
Mata
of
in there
decent
as
names.
well.
There's a Japanese in there. There's Mata there too. But I think Kali Lloyd will win this one.
Okay.
There's no competition in there.
All
There's
right.
no
Okay.
competition.
Let's have a look at the composition. You have three Germans on that list. You have
Yeah.
a Swede, a Canadian, one American, one Brazilian, and one Japanese. No Nigerian.
Yeah,
Should the Nigerians have been there?
No. The only Nigerian of note has to be Asada Shola, and she had a poor season.
Okay.
Just a goal or two in 11 games.
So how would the winner be selected, and what day?
Winner will be selected on the 9th of January, and FIFA have made it clear 50% of the votes will be made up of national team
captain and coaches.
The other 50% and an
online
poll, and 200 media representatives around the world. So this is much more transparent.
It's
and
going
you
to
can,
be fairer.
Yeah, it can be. You can. It's empiric. Let me use that word in there. So, but I mentioned that no African has made it, but an African woman made it in the Coach of the Year shortlist.
Okay.
Vera Powell, the South African coach. She's made it into this list of the best coaches. So we wish her the best in that one. But I think it's still a long shot for an African player to really make it in there. You ask yourself, how much quality players are we producing?
Okay.
How much impact are we making in the world stage? Until we start doing that, I don't think we can crack this code.